Hey there, it's Mallory here with All About Cats, and in this week's video we're going to be taking a look at Dr. Marty Nature's Feast cat food. So you might have heard of Dr. Marty Goldstein. There was fairly recently a documentary centering around him called The Dog Doc. He's kind of a celebrity veterinarian known for having practiced on the pets of Martha Stewart, Oprah, Jerry Seinfeld, some other celebrities, and he's a pretty prominent figure in this world of alternative medicine, integrative medicine for pets. He fairly recently came out with a line of food for pets, including this cat food, which I'll be talking about in this video. So I'll be giving you a full breakdown of this food, talking about its background, its nutritional merits. I sent it off to an independent lab in order to get it nutritionally analyzed, so I'll be telling you about that. And I'm also going to be telling you about how my own cats reacted to it. So I put it out in the house and invited them to try, and I'll be telling you how Wessie and Forrest responded. So first off, let's talk about the background of Dr. Marty Nature's Feast. Again, Dr. Marty is this celebrity veterinarian, and he's known for this kind of maverick approach to taking care of pets. That was kind of the central focus in the movie The Dog Doc. Dr. Marty is known for making some kind of dramatic claims about his food. For instance, he implies that it's going to help your cat to live a longer and healthier, happier life. And he also makes some claims about the alternatives to his food. So if you watch his little infomercial or video sales letter on the Cat Food Exposed website, you'll see that he makes a number of claims about the ingredients used in other foods, like preservatives, byproducts, fillers. A lot of claims that these are health-destroying ingredients. And while, as you'll see if you watch the video or read around Dr. Marty Goldstein's website, some of the claims made out about this food are kind of lofty, and it's made out to be this really innovative and radical food, it looks a lot like other freeze-dried raw foods on the market. Arguably, this is a controversial area in feline nutrition, but I've tried a number of freeze-dried raw foods. My cats really like them, and anecdotally at least, these do seem to be healthy options for cats. The food is made in a facility in North America, and the company doesn't really go into specifics on where its ingredients are sourced, so we're a little bit in the dark on that, and we don't really know that much about the quality of the ingredients used. Now again, this is a relatively new brand, so a lack of recalls doesn't really mean all that much, but I wasn't able to find any recalls associated with Dr. Marty's Nature's Feast cat food. So Dr. Marty Pets only offers one cat food recipe. It's their Nature's Feast recipe, and it contains a blend of multiple different animal protein sources. So the first ingredient is salmon. It also contains turkey and whitefish. These are the first three ingredients. And then the food contains chicken liver, heart, and gizzards, which are all rich sources of animal-derived nutrients. Now, this food is not fortified with any synthetic vitamins, minerals, or amino acids. This is something that a number of freeze-dried raw foods do, because freeze-drying doesn't degrade the nutrients present in raw food, and so you're able to use these ingredient sources of nutrients. Dr. Marty's claims that this is a more bioavailable form of these nutrients. The company claims that in addition to these vitamins and minerals provided through those additional ingredients, these ingredients are sources of prebiotic fiber, which help to promote probiotic activity in the gut. And so these can help to potentially support healthy digestion and overall well-being. So we're seeing that this recipe also includes sweet potato, flaxseed, pumpkin seed, a number of berries, as well as carrots. There's just a nice little array of fruits and vegetables added to this recipe. And it also contains egg. So there are a total of five different proteins in this recipe. Now, as for how my cats reacted to the food, both of them liked it. Wessie seemed to have a preference for the food when it was in its rehydrated state, whereas Forrest liked to just eat it dry. And both of these are valid options when you're feeding Dr. Marty Nature's Feast. So in order to find out exactly what was in this food, I sent it off to an independent third-party lab, and I got a nutritional analysis done. So according to this analysis, the food is, on a dry matter basis, 37% protein, 33% fat, which is significantly higher than the minimum level listed on the guaranteed analysis, and 22% carbohydrates. Again, all on a dry matter basis with moisture removed. All of these values are within the range of the guaranteed analysis, but it does present a little bit of a different picture of the food. For example, we're seeing that the food is relatively high carbohydrate, even though it's kind of marketed as a low carbohydrate food. Generally, we would be looking for something under 10% carbohydrates, although cats can metabolize carbohydrates, and the evidence that a low carb food is better is kind of limited. There is some evidence that it might be better to feed a low carbohydrate food that's less than 10% carbohydrates on a dry matter basis. I also looked at the food's sodium and phosphorus content. Phosphorus seems to be about typical for cat food, certainly not nearly as high as we would see in some other freeze-dried foods like from Stella and Chewy's, which tend to be pretty high phosphorus because they contain bone. And finally, the analysis found that the food had 457 milligrams of sodium per 100 grams. So while we don't really have a good idea of what constitutes too much sodium in a cat's diet, this amount generally falls within the guidelines of appropriate sodium levels for cats. So overall, it looks like this food has kind of moderate protein content, moderate fat content, and then relatively high carbohydrate content compared to what we could generally consider to be a species appropriate ideal. You can find a lot of other freeze-dried raw foods that have much higher meat content and much lower carbohydrate content, while also incorporating some of these food-derived nutrients. So for example, I know that Vital Essentials kind of follows this model, but they incorporate significantly lower levels of plant-derived ingredients. So we talked about this food's background and its nutritional qualities, but how much does it cost? So there are a couple of different ways you can buy Dr. Marty's Nature's Feast cat food. One is to go through the Cat Food Exposed website, which has a little infomercial, and then you'll click through and then you'll get a discounted rate on the cat food. But the price that you're going to get there is a bit lower than what you're going to see on the Dr. Marty Pets website. So on the Dr. Marty Pets website, you can buy a 12-ounce bag for over $50, breaking down to $4.99 per ounce. And if you buy it through that sales page, your price per ounce is going to be significantly lower at around $3.33. Regardless of where you buy Dr. Marty Nature's Feast, it's really expensive. So considering that a 1¼ cup daily portion weighs a little over 2 ounces, you're going to end up going through one of these bags for a 10-pound cat in about 5 days. Compared to other freeze-dried raw foods on the market, including those that use kind of novel protein sources like duck and rabbit, this is really expensive. You can get Stella and Chewy's for closer to $4 per day. You can get Vital Essentials for maybe $6, $7 a day for their most expensive formulas. And considering that this food contains pretty standard ingredients and a nice mix of ingredients at that, it really doesn't seem to me to be worth the money. Now, of course, the whole Dr. Marty premise is that you're getting this food formulated by this veterinarian who has this kind of magic touch, so to speak, with pets. But from what I can tell, this food is a pretty ordinary product. It's nothing magical. It's nothing that should be able to give your cat a longer, healthier life any more than any other similar cat food. That being said, those who have chosen to buy Dr. Marty Nature's Feast do generally seem to be happy with it. A lot of customers will point out the high price, but the customer reviews that I've seen generally seem to be positive. Most of them are on the Dr. Marty website. There are some on some other platforms, and they get an A+ grade from the Better Business Bureau. So overall, it does seem that people are pretty happy with their experience with Dr. Marty cat food. The price really seems to be the biggest downside of it. So overall, is Dr. Marty Nature's Feast cat food going to be a good choice? Well, the food receives fairly high marks in terms of species appropriateness. If you don't mind that relatively high carbohydrate content, it seems to have fairly good ingredient quality. I've noticed that customers seem to be pretty happy with it. And of course, they have a fairly good reputation in terms of recall history and consistency. That being said, the food does have pretty big downsides, and the biggest one is its price. The other one is product variety is really low. You only get one recipe, and it has this mix of protein sources. So if your cat has food sensitivities or allergies, this food isn't going to be a good choice for them. It contains a mix of fish and chicken, with egg. And overall, it's just not really a food that's going to be friendly to cats with food intolerances or these types of sensitivities. The other issue that I take with this food is it just seems kind of gimmicky. There just seem to be a lot of claims that are a little bit questionable on the site. And combined with the extremely high price, it seems like you're more being sold on the idea that this is coming from this veterinarian with this reputation than anything else. It really does look like a fairly ordinary freeze-dried raw food. There are a lot of competing brands that are offering similar foods at a significantly lower price. So overall, it's going to end up getting a C plus grade just because it just does not do well in those areas of product variety and price. It's a fairly solid food overall, but those areas just really take it down a few notches. So if you are interested in giving Dr. Marty's cat food a try, I'll put links in the description so that you can check it out for yourself. If you're interested in learning more about Dr. Marty cat food and some of the other options available in the Dr. Marty Pets lineup, you can read the written version of this review. One of our reviewers purchased this food, tried it out with her cats, and wrote an in-depth review of the brand. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you're interested in more cat food brand reviews, buyer's guides, and general information on all things cats, please subscribe to the All About Cats channel with new videos coming out at least once a week. You should always have something to look forward to. So, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.